free $1,000 that somebody sent me the mail. I'm like, cool, free money. No, bitch, it wasn't free. YouTube, it's your girl Candace. I am back with another video. If you are new, hi, welcome to the team, y'all. My name is Candace Renee. Here on my channel, we do entrepreneur vlogs, advice vlogs, really sit down talk videos, just anything that I can help you guys out with. And if you are returning, you should already be subscribed. What you doing if you're not subscribed? Go ahead and subscribe to my channel and make sure to give it a thumbs up so YouTube knows that we get lit over here, okay? In today's video, if you guys do not follow me on Instagram, if you don't, you should, the link will be down below. I talked to you guys about how I was going to do a credit video, how to maintain good credit, how to get good credit, and how to get approved for anything, almost anything that you want, and what lenders look for when they are running your credit to approve you for like a car. I want to go ahead and give a disclaimer before I start this video. I am not a financial advisor. I am not a credit specialist. I do not fix credit. This is what worked for me. This is my advice, my experience with having credit. So I cannot give nobody no financial advice. Please do not take this as like financial advice. This is just something that worked for me. It could possibly work for you. I just want you guys to just know my experience and take what you can out of my experience and how it could possibly help you. So I just have to throw that disclaimer out there. So if you guys want to know how to maintain good credit, how to get good credit, and what lenders look for when they're approving you for stuff, keep on watching. So basically, I'm gonna talk about me. So basically, my credit got messed up. It's a long story how my credit got messed up, but basically I had messed up credit since 2016. I had messed up credit for about 4 or 5 years. I just repaired my credit, I wanna say in July. I just repaired my credit in July, and I only did it because I was trying to get approved for the apartment that I'm in right now, and I did not want to pay no extra big deposit. And here they had approved me with conditions. So when you get an apartment, you either get approved, approval conditions, or denied. I got approved with conditions because my credit score was not that bad, but a lot of people don't even look at the score, y'all. So we're gonna actually get into that. They really don't look at the score. But they approved me with conditions, and they wanted me to pay an extra $50 a month on top of this really big deposit. Now, mind you, the rent here in my apartment now is already high. So if I don't have to pay anything extra, I'm not gonna pay nothing extra. So I said, okay, I'm gonna fix my credit. I'm gonna let them rerun my credit, and I'm gonna get approved, and I'm not gonna have to pay anything extra. So I'm gonna tell you guys what I did to repair my credit and some things that were on my credit that you guys can avoid. I had collections on my credit. I had charge-offs on my credit. And I had a voluntary repossession on my credit, which was like basically a repossession. So a long time ago, my credit got messed up because I let this guy that I was messing with, he basically took all my money. Basically, it's a long story. He took all my money. My account was in the negatives, and I had to let everything go bad. I had to let all my credit cards go bad, and I had to let my car go bad because around this time I had no job and I could not afford to pay my credit cards or my car note or anything anymore. So I let everything go bad. I did not want to file for bankruptcy because I didn't want bankruptcy on my credit for 5 years, and it's just, bankruptcy is just complicated, and I did not want that on my credit. So I said, I'm gonna just let everything go bad, and then I'm gonna try to repair it later. So what happened was, as I let my car go back in a voluntary possession. So a voluntary possession is basically where you give your car back. Now, just because you give your car back does not mean they're gonna put voluntary repossession on your credit. If you do a voluntary repossession, it is going to go as a repossession on your credit. It's not gonna say, oh, she just gave it back. No, it's gonna go as a repossession. So when lenders look at you, when lenders look at your credit, they're going to see repossession. So they're gonna think your car got repossessed and you couldn't pay for it. When that's not the case, you could have gave the car back for any reason whatsoever and it wouldn't had nothing to do with the cost. But if you voluntarily repossess your car, it's going to show up as a repossession on your credit. So if you can avoid not giving your car back to the bank or your lender, do that, because a voluntary repossession is really, really, really hard to get off of your credit. Not gonna lie to you, it's very hard. I had to keep disputing after I paid them. It's a long story. We're gonna get into that, but I just wanted to let you guys know that if you guys are not familiar with what a voluntary possession was, try not to get that on your credit. Try to pay the car in some way, shape, or form. Just try. Or if anything, just let them charge it off. Either way it goes, it's still gonna be bad, but you know, at least it'll show up as a charge off instead of a repossession, which they're both bad, but one is more bad than the other. So basically, how I paid it is, honestly, so it's people out here who fix credit. Not knocking the people who fix credit, but to me, it's like, if you have the money, just work. I know a lot of people say, don't pay your collections, da 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 da. You guys, I'm not gonna lie to you. I had like 6 collections debt on my credit, all from credit card lenders that I didn't pay. And I literally paid, I settled with them. So when you have a debt on, when you have a collections on your credit, you can settle in full, which means that you and your creditor settle on an amount, you pay them for that, the lesser, or no, it's called settle for a lesser amount. And what you can do is that you and your lender can talk and you guys can come to an agreement, you can negotiate with them, come to an agreement, and you can just go ahead and pay them and they will close the collection debt for you. So I'm gonna be honest with y'all, that's the best thing. Or you can do a payment plan for the amount settled. Like, you could pay them half now and pay them the other half in 2 weeks, which is what I did for my car that I voluntarily repossessed, because I owed them $8,000. I owed them $8,000 because that's what I had left on my loan after they sold it at auction. I owed them $8,000, but I didn't pay them $8,000. I paid them $1,200 and it got off my credit because we were able to come up with an amount. So the lenders will work with you because they don't, I'm gonna be real with y'all, collections, they do not really want their money, because first of all, it's already a loss anyways. It's already a loss. They don't care. They really don't care. They don't care to have all their money. It's already a loss, especially if the collection has been on your credit for years. They don't care. They don't want that whole money back because it's already a loss to them. It don't matter. It's already a loss. So you can settle it for a lesser amount. Like, I don't know why people tell you not to do that. People tell you, oh, send in this and send in this letter and send in that letter. I'm gonna be real with y'all. The fastest way to get that off your credit is to call the collections agency. First of all, call them from a restricted number, because if you call them from your regular phone number, there's something called skip tracing. So if y'all don't know, I work at a finance company. I work for an auto finance company in the collections department, so I know all the tea. So if nobody tells you, I'm telling you. So when you call a collections agency to try to settle your debt for a lesser amount, call them from a restricted number, because what will happen is if you call them from your regular number, they will have your regular number on file. Even if they don't have that number already, they'll have it on file. They'll do something called a skip trace, where they'll take that number and they'll look it up in either TransUnion or Experian or what's another one? I can't think right now, but they'll look it up in a skip tracing thing and they'll look your number up and they'll see if it's you. They'll see that it's you, and then they will document that and they will call that number every single day. Trust and believe, they will do it. So always call them from restricted so they don't have your number. And once you call them from restricted, work out a deal. Once you work out that deal, they can either, you can either pay them that amount, or you can set up a payment plan where you pay them half of that amount now, half of that amount later. I would never pay a collections agency the full amount, because first of all, it's not worth it no more. You don't have the card, the loan is years old, the money's gone from the loan. Don't ever pay them the full amount. Always settle it in full. Once you settle it in full, it'll take about maybe 2 to 3 weeks to close. Once the account is closed, you can go on your credits. You can go on Credit Karma. You can go on Experian, one of them websites, and you can dispute it and say that you settled it for a lesser amount, or you settle it in full. And then once you dispute it, it comes off your credit. That's my personal experience that has happened to me. You also want them to send you a letter, so always make sure that they send you a letter basically saying that you guys agreed to this amount, and that's that. I'm telling y'all, I know that y'all do not want to pay these people any money. I know that y'all want to do the letter route and all that stuff like that, but y'all, I'm trying to tell you, if you have the money, see if you can work out a deal. That's the fastest thing. I've already tried the whole sending letters. I paid a credit specialist. It didn't do no good. The fastest way to get this off your credit is to just settle it. Just settle it for a lesser amount. Once it's settled for a lesser amount, the account will close. Once the account closed, dispute it, it'll be gone in about 30, 60 days. Boom. That's it. I know y'all probably was looking for like a real deep answer, but I'm trying to tell y'all that is the fastest way to get something off your credit if you have the money. And if you don't even have the full money that you're trying to agree to, you try to negotiate with them. Try to negotiate, see what you can come up with. If y'all come up with something, or if they come up with something that's not what you can do, set up a payment plan with them. They will take a payment plan. If they don't take, they legally have to take a payment plan. Trust me, I work in collections. I know they legally have to take a payment plan, and like, they take a payment plan, boom, it's done. So that's the easiest way, y'all. Now, how to maintain and keep good credit. So once you have good credit, right now my credit score is like in the mid 700s. All my credit score is really good. Around this time last year, I had like a 630 something. Now I have like a 720 something credit score. So that's what I did to get my credit score up and to get my collections and my charge-offs off, is basically settling the amount, and doing payment plans and working with my lenders. Now, what can you do to maintain good credit? To maintain good credit, y'all, is to pay your bills. I know it's like, I know y'all was looking for like this really fancy answer, but that's it. That's tea. Pay your bills, y'all. Don't let your credit utilization should not be over 30%. 30% or less. I believe it's 30%. Don't go over 30%. I know that. 30% or less for your credit utilization. Don't try to use your credit cards. Pay your credit card. Use your credit cards a little bit, and then turn around and pay it off as soon as possible. Because don't just not use your credit card at all. And the reason why I say that is because your credit score, or Experian, TransUnion, whoever's behind all that stuff, they want to see that you are able to use credit, and they want to see that you're responsible enough to pay it back. So use your credit card, pay it back. Use your credit card, pay it back as fast as possible, because they want to see stuff like that. But really, just pay your bills on time. Don't let anything get behind. Don't let anything get past due. Just pay your bills on time. That's the best thing I can tell you, is to just pay your bills on time and use your credit card a little bit. Don't use it. Use your credit card a little bit. Don't use it. That's the best thing. That's what's been working for me. Is to just pay your credit card. That's it. Pay that credit card. Pay it up, sis. Pay it up. Pay that credit card, sis. You know, pay that credit card, pay utilities, make sure you pay your rent on time. Utilities, I pay utilities, and I haven't seen any utilities on my credit. But pay your utilities on time, because they do look at that. If you're like, for example, with Georgia Power, everybody doesn't have Georgia Power, but for my power company, it's Georgia Power, and power companies do look, if you're trying to get your power turned on at one spot to another, if you don't pay your bill on time with Georgia Power, I keep saying Georgia Power, everybody don't have Georgia Power, but I'm just gonna speak on Georgia Power. With Georgia Power, if you're trying to like get your lights cut on at a new spot, if you not pay, if they see you didn't pay your light bill on time, they're gonna make you put down a deposit. So you wanna always make sure to pay your utilities on time. Now let me tell you guys something about a loan. Do not get a loan that you feel like you can never pay back. When I was younger, okay, so let me tell you guys this quick little story. When I was younger, this finance company randomly sent me $1,000 check and it was a loan. And I never paid them back. I cashed a check, never paid them back. And because I didn't pay them back, they put that in collections on my credit. And that was in collections on my credit for like years. And so I didn't really plan to pay them back. But I would basically say, and I didn't even have the money to pay them back. I just saw a free $1,000 that somebody sent me in the mail. And I'm like, cool, free money. No. Bitch, it wasn't free. Get no loans that you cannot pay back. You have to pay back these loans. Do not go take out a $40,000 loan with super dumb high interest rate and you know that you cannot pay that loan back. That loan is $700, $800 a month to pay back. You just spent all these folk money and you can't pay it back. Don't do it, because you're gonna F yourself up. Don't do it. Be responsible. Take out loans that you know that you can pay back, that's reasonable for you. What else? Now we're gonna talk about what lenders look for when they are pulling your credit. So like I said, I work for an auto finance company and I got to work a little bit with the credit department at my auto finance job. And so I kind of know what they're looking for. So when you go get a car and they pull your credit, it really does not matter about the score. That's tea. They do not look at the score. These places do not care if you got an 800 credit score. I mean, if you got an 800 credit score, you should be good. But I'm saying they don't really look at the score. They look at the stuff on your credit. They look at your late payment history. So you have a late payment history percentage. If your late payment history percentage is over 30%, they're going to higher your interest rate because you're gonna be looked at as a high risk. So they're gonna higher the interest rate. They also look at the amount. They also look at the times that you've been late. So they'll look if you have, like, for example, if you have a credit card and you've been late one or two times, you still good, because they understand that, like, okay, you may have had a situation or you may not have gotten your check on time to be able to pay the payment, so you may have been a day or two late. So if you have one or two late payments, then it's cool. But if you got like 10, 20 late payments, that's gonna make you look like a high risk to a lender. Also, when it comes down to your auto, so if this is like your second car, you had a first car, they look at stuff like that too. They look at your late payments. They look to see if you have a lot of late payments. They look to see if the loan is closed. They look to see how much you owe. They also look at your debt. They also look at your debt to income ratio. I think I'm saying that right. So with your debt to income ratio, they look, so when you go get a car, and they tell you to write down how much you make annually. They look at your paycheck stubs. They look at your paycheck stubs to see how much that you make a month. If you owe more than how much you make in income, that's a debt to income ratio. So if you make more money than what you owe in debt, they look at stuff like that and they're gonna be like, okay, I don't know if she got a lot of debt and she making this much, like she owe $18,000 in debt but she only making $2,000 a month. I don't know. So they gonna question it and they gonna look at it, and that kind of determines what type of interest rate they give you, what type of payment they give you. And with lenders, they try to give you the best possible. So what they do is, the car salesman, they'll shop your deal around, they'll shop how much you're trying to get a loan for, and they'll shop around your credit and they'll try to give you the best deal possible. So that's what they do. So if you ever go to a car dealership and they pull your credit like 20, 30 times, it's because they're trying to shop you around, basically, is what they look for. They don't necessarily look at the score. They look at the stuff on your credit. They look at your payment history, your debt to ratio history. They look at if you've had any bankruptcies. They look if you had any collections, any closed accounts, stuff like that determines it. So If you want to get a car and you got a lot of stuff, I would say fix your credit up, try to get some stuff off your credit, because it does not matter about the score. It matters about the stuff on your credit. They don't care about the score. If anything, they don't even really, I mean, they pull the score, but they give you a list of like the stuff that's on there. They don't really get, you know, you don't really get the score. Like, the score really doesn't matter. So that is what lenders look for when they are approving you for a car. And that kind of goes for, you know, cars, mortgages, credit cards, stuff like that. That's really what they look for. It's not necessarily about the score, it's about the stuff on there. So that is the credit video here. I hope that you guys enjoyed this. I hope that this helped you out. I hope this gave you some insight about credit, how you can fix your credit, what lenders are looking for. So if you go get a car or a credit card or anything like that, then you know what you need to fix on your credit before you go apply. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope this video helped. Comment below if this video helped you, and I will see you guys in my next video.